name is Simi and you're watching Broadway TV. What's up everyone, it's Nikky Laoye and you are watching Broadway TV. Don't touch it.
Music. Music means a lot to me. Music means music like second air for me. You know, as soon as I breathe, I sing. As soon as I breathe, I sing. So music means a lot to me. Aside from music being my number one hobby, it now happens to be my profession. Yeah, it happens to be my opportunity to speak up for my activism. Music is like an avenue for me to express myself in a lot of ways. So music means a lot to me. It's like everything to me. Everything. Controversies, I don't think it's possible for you to be able to do anything in this world without attracting controversy. Even if you choose to be a regular pop star and only make music about champagne and girls shaking a bum bum in the club, people will still criticize that. And then people might not like the way you said bum bum on the song or the way you said you talk about money too much. And so I don't think it's possible for you to not have controversy, especially as a public figure, you're like an artist. So I think the amount of controversy Brymo attracts, it's because of the kind of stuff, the kind of topic Brymo likes to approach. And so I don't think I can do without that. You know what I'm saying? So I think that would be the whole record label going to court saga. That lasted like 2 years. So that was really big. That was really big.
So how did you feel about Lagos coming? I can imagine as a winner
Oh, well, of course, I'm a Lagosian, so I'm excited. Once again, it's coming right here. Well, it's been, this is going to be the third year that Lagos is going to be hosting the AFRIMA Awards. So, of course, I'm excited because it's always fun out here in Lagos. Yeah, we rock. Yeah.
Okay, so, quick question. Are you
being
controversial?
No, I ain't no controversial nobody. I'm just myself with you. I'm a very good person. Nikki's good. She's sweet. She's kind. Everybody loves Nikki.
So, how do you feel about Lagos emerging as a winner to host AFRIMA 2016?
Well, I'm flattered on behalf of Lagos. You know, I mean, people get to come here and experience the culture here, you know, and like, Africans can come together and just bond, you know, so I'm really excited to be a part of that.
What should we expect from AFRIMA 2016? And of course, are you hoping to be a nominee?
I'm definitely hoping that I'm a nominee, but you know, I'm also hoping that that people just, there's a bonding or like unifying spirit, regardless of who's nominated or not, just, you know, just to meet people, you know, that I haven't met before and just, you know, connect.
What exactly should we expect from AFRIMA 2016?
Of African culture and music, and we also have this important role of promoting the young artist. So we see AFRIMA as a platform which promotes and provides recognition to the young artist, young African artist.
Okay, so how far do you see the vision here for AFRIMA? How far do you think that's got?
It's building up and it's going very far. We started, of course, there are challenges, but through this collaboration that the African Union has with AFRIMA, we try to minimize the challenges and recognizing, like I said, and promoting the African artist.
So how do you feel about Lagos emerging as a winner?
Oh, it's amazing. We're really happy for the city of Lagos, but the way we see it as all the other cities being also winners of this process. There's no losers as we see it. But Lagos, I think, deserves also the opportunity to host such an event as this one. It has experience in doing so. It has hosted many other renowned platforms in the past. So I think it's only normal, natural that Lagos should be the flag bearer this time around. Well, we're hoping that we will have the capacity to federate an increasing number of Pan-African artists. as you've seen today, we had in a room several Nigerian artists, which is a fabulous thing because I think in the global scene, they are very visible and they're really trying to elevate the level of visibility of African music and culture in general. So it's a fundamental thing. But we're really hoping that beyond the borders of the West African region, we will be able to federate artists from Cape to Congo to Cairo, to Ethiopia, Djibouti, etc. So look out for that. There will be, I think, a new breed of artists that will be showcased this time.